Welcome back, everyone, for the next part of Etrian Odyssey Nexus. It's time for our walk with Wolfgut Jr. Oh, I'm so happy that he's back. He was my favorite in the second game. It's really nice that they included him. Also, I see that there's a treasure chest right there. We should mark that down. So, now that we are in this big room, our little buddy. Ah, it's those things again. I see. I don't like them. Oh, they walk in circles? Okay. I mean, I don't mind that. Not sure how far you're gonna fly, though. That probably won't be following me, right? How about I draw this as a yellow line? Yeah, let's draw this as a yellow line. That might be a better choice. Since he's kind of flying around us, like that. Let's see. Nope, nope, he's not aggressive, he won't follow me around. That's good to know, because then I'm able to avoid him. Let's wait for him once more. Get past here. Into this safe corner, right, left to us. Oh, there's no wall here. Why did I draw that wall? Also, this is dangerous here. This is dangerous here. Then it's going to continue until here. Then he's going to move right around here. And from what I can see, there has to be some kind of connection like this. But oh well. We don't need to go that way just yet. We have a different way which we want to follow, right? No need to proceed a little dead end. This probably doesn't even have anything of worth to us. Oh god, I hate those things. Let's grab the shortcut first. Seriously? Grab that shortcut first, okay. Thank you. I see I almost have an encounter. Could be dangerous. See, it continues on like this. There's an entrance. Like this. Then we have this here. Goes up. But it's a dead end for me. Okay. Let's see. He's gonna appear around there. This area is safe, right? This area, I mean, is safe, right? This is dangerous because he's going to fly up here. There's no wall here. Cannot walk upwards because he's going to catch me. So, okay, there is a way up. I see another treasure, kinda like there. Let's see where this is going. Nothing. Oh, I hate this. It's flying completely up like this. Gonna catch me. It's gonna catch me. Time for escape. I screwed that up. Wolfgar! No! As you return to the city, Wolfgar Jr. howls to notify you he's heading back to the labyrinth. Oh, Wolfgar! There must be a reason why he won't leave the maze. You may see him if you visit the labyrinth again. Oh, Wolfgar! Come on! I just want another thread to tell me I'm instantly back! You didn't have to leave me and break my heart. Even though I could grab a quest, since there are probably some quests in here. That request? Let me see. It's from the workshop. The workshop is actually quite interesting. They make fake food there. You know the models in glass cases outside of the restaurants that shows customers what's on the menu? They do an amazing job. The fake looks just like the real thing. Maybe next time I should ask them to make a model for me. Then I could skip work and relax. No? Well then maybe I'll have them make one of you, so you can watch over the tavern. Anyways, the request. They want you to get these newly discovered permanent crystals. The crystals' colors perfect for mimicking grapes, and they want to use them to model a fruit parfait. They want at least two, but wouldn't mind having up to six. You can work harder if you like a bigger reward. Mining spots. I could probably already do that. Finish it, since I have a few. The request comes from one of the librarians in the National Library. He wants to find out more about the creature that lives in Adam Bridge. He's actually here in the tavern right now. Why don't you go talk to him? Oh, he is, huh? Oh, hello! Did you need something from me? Yeah. I see. Thank you so much. This will be a great help to me. My name is Fitch. Ever since I was young, I've been fascinated by birds. I often find myself watching the skies and studying them from afar in my spare time. Invariably, I end up wishing that I could take to the skies and join them someday. In fact, I admit that the sole reason I moved to Magenia is because I heard it was a flying city. At any rate, to my request. I've heard that the Pedal Bridge is home to numerous bird monsters. As the forests are their domain, I fall prey to them in an instant where I'd personally venture there. So your role is to go to the Pedal Bridge and register bird monster. Could you register four or more kinds and come show them to me? Natural, the more kinds of bird monster that you show me, the greater your reward. So I'm going to keep that quest until I finish the complete dungeon, right? That doesn't sound so bad. For now. Wolfgar! Wolfgar! There you are, my little boy. It seems that Wolfgar Jr. was waiting for you. Oh, you're so kind. He emits a low growl and appears to be following you. You decide to continue your exploration. Ah, my best buddy. Too bad he won't follow us forever. I mean, I don't mind having two dogs following me. After all, nothing beats a dog companion. So let's see. That's a dead end, so I actually need to walk that way. That's good to know, right? I don't know if the left wall is correct. This is as far as I can go. Just one further. Oh my god! I could have walked away. I could have walked the whole way. Why did I? Oh, I'm so stupid. I'm so stupid. Come on. 2, 3. Continue on like this. And this. And goes like this. Now there's a giant bird coming along on the other side. So let's just wait for him. So there's an exit like this and a long corridor like this. And it's gonna keep flying over there. So there's an interaction between those two birds. That's good to know. This is safe, right? An Excella. What's that? Items? Excella. Powerful potion made by boiling sweet veins. Ah, Force Scout. Could have used that in the last battle when I was waiting for mine. Which took forever to charge. Also, it seems like that thing goes too far. Kinda like this. Well. Better wait for that bird to come. Okay, that's wrongly colored. It won't go that far. Okay. Okay, that thing is coming right here. So it's this giant circle. Question is, how am I supposed to get that treasure that's all the way over there? Oh well. Let's continue first. Maybe after I kill that bird, I grab that treasure. I mean, it's not a force treasure I need to get no matter what, right? It's just a random treasure I could get. I see that there is a corner like this there. Moves up like this. There's a door. Anything of interest here? Tucked away in a corner of a clearing, you spot a bird nest in the tree. The nest is positioned on a rather low branch, so you can see something glimmering in it from where you stand. The nest seems to be made from a wide variety of materials. You consider whether or not to check out whatever is shining in it. Are we going to disturb the nest? We're probably going to fight, but do it. Let's do it. Curious about the glimmer, you head over to peek into the nest. At that moment, the nest owner appeared. The bird flaps their wing in a threatening pose, then swoops overhead, barely missing you. Clearly, they have designated you as a threat. There's no time to flee. I knew that would happen. Oh, you are the ravens, so element attack are useless against you. And swallow, and star drop, and power shot, and nerf circle. Bam bam! Don't do so much damage. Benny just killed you, so that means blood bands activates, right? Right? Yes! Power shot! Oh my god. You poor little guy. Having dispatched the enemy, you once again turned your attention to their nest. You don't know where they originally came from, but the nest is comprised of a number of coins. You take the coins for yourself, then once again return to your exploration. Well, that's quite a nice reward for disturbing your nest. Good that there weren't any eggs in it, just some coins. Or else I would have felt bad about killing their parents. At least a tiny bit, since those are monsters. And they are not the chick I was protecting in the other game. Oh, what's that? Ah, the platform. Right, the platform. It's gonna be annoying. Soon. Very soon. As you proceed along the path, you notice a mysterious floating tile to the south. Wolfgard, are you going to show me that we can fly on that? The jet black beast looks at it, barks at you softly, then leaps nimbly upon it. Bye, Wolfgard! You consider whether or not you follow him. Not now. Let's just map this out first. You stop at a dead end in the labyrinth as the comfortably breeze blows in from over the wall. Oh, that's water. When you feel the breeze, the wind carries a delicious scent to your nose. You follow the smell and find a small group of adventurers in the middle of a meal break. When they see you, they greet you with a wave. Hey, princess! Aria! Aria hands you a cup, inviting you to eat with them. The cup is filled with a warm soup. The steam is emitting, making it look very appetizing. The soup's a very simple recipe, but it tastes exquisite, like due to the freshness of the ingredient harvested within the labyrinth. You don the soup with gusto and enjoy a nice chef with your newfound companion. Full heal! The party recovers! Eventually, the other guild concludes the break and departs before your own does. Bye, my friends! Happy that you had the opportunity to enjoy the pleasant meal, to refine to yourself the importance of helping out fellow explorers. You also resolve to keep pace with them as you return to your own exploration. That's why you're going to share your guild card with everyone. Unless you want to have that kinky guy with the blade guild or how they called appear everywhere, that's also fine. I don't like them so much, so I'm happy about all that guys I have. Oh. Let's grab this shortcut really quick, which I completely forgot. Get that mining torch. Oh, it instantly reminds itself. Yeah, I got the stuff, but I'd always need more, right? So let's go back. I see there are two of them. Which means I need. I'll check this one first. Just for the heck of it. Since there's another event. And why did I draw that? And why did I draw this? This has to be blue. What the hell? Yeah. Didn't place an E marker. E marker. During your exploration, you stumble upon a long stick lying on the ground of by the shore. You pick it up, then notice that there's a string tied to one end of it, and at the end of the string is some makeshift bait and a hook or angle. It appears to be a handmade fishing rod. You consider whether or not to try the fish. Oh, sure! You take the fishing rod and cast it pretty far into the water, where the fish but the fish has no interest in biting. Perhaps the bait isn't working? Keep at it. You will cast the line. Drop the hook very far from the shore. But again, the fish don't bite at all. You get a feeling that you've learned why the rod was abandoned here in the first place. Keep at it. Refusing to give up, you wind back, then cast the line as hard as you can, pinching the hook far into the water. Yet again, not a single bite. You give up and start reeling in the line. Once you begin reeling, feel a strong resistance. Based on the weight, it could just be caught on something. But the line is slowly approaching the shore. It feels like this could be a real deal. Hold your breath and concentrate on reeling in the bounty. After a real effort, you manage to yank the line out of the water. Hanging from the hook is a sopping wet leatherback. You're disappointed that it wasn't a fish, but you cut the back open off the line and check inside, just to be thoroughly. Oh, nectar! Yes. It took quite a bit of time, but your patience has paid off. Please return to your exploration. Thank you for that. Nectar is always good, right? You can always use it. And during the last boss battle, I even had to use one, so that makes it even better for me right now. I see something like this, continuing in this direction. Not sure how many tiles, but oh well. Then we jump over here. Nothing of interest here. Okay. Guess I'm gonna get my shortcut soon. After riding upon the floating tiles, you arrive at the other side. The friendly beast runs on ahead. No! Wolfgard! Don't leave me! He excitedly wags his tail at a woman who kneels before him with a faint smile. Yes! Oh my god! It's just getting better! It's just getting better! Junior, you're back! Did you find any sailor over there? As the woman talks to the beast, she finally notices you behind her and leaps to her feet. Hey, I've never seen you before. Are you adventurers from Marginia? The woman takes out her weapon and eyes you with caution. Let's introduce ourselves. The woman seems surprised by your answer. She absentmindedly rubs the hound's fur and mutters under her breath with a nervous look. I see. So they really did come here, on that flying city. She then introduced herself as Atrinlinde, the one from Etrian Odyssey 2, an adventurer working as a guard for the Seafair Princess Fleet. She pats the back of the jet black beast, who she introduced as Wolfgard Jr., her partner. What about Gunter? Oh my god, I forgot his name. The old man. She adds that his father was a seasoned adventurer. Atrinlinde stands up, pointing to the north. If you advance beyond the Petal Bridge, you will arrive at the Seafar base. It's a solid staging ground, close to the ocean. The Seafar are currently scurrying in their quest to find the Lemuria treasures. I was part of the scouting team, and the rest of them should have landed about 6 months ago. I've been trying to regroup with them. I'm in a hurry, since the Seafar Princess is so impatient. She almost rushed out here herself, so that's what has led me here. It's probably good that you ran into me first. The Seafar and the Marginia are enemies. What? No! I'm sure those in Marginia would verify this. The conflict goes back generation. There's this ancient legend. Well, it's really ugly. At that, Arianda and Wolfgar... No! Don't leave me! I need them! I'm going to continue searching for that scout team. If you want a piece of advice, you probably shouldn't proceed any further. But I need to. I can't picture a meeting between Virginia and adventurers and safeguards going very smoothly. But our meeting wasn't that bad. And Wolfgard was really nice. With those final words, Adelinda takes her leave with Wolfgard in tow. Taking notes that the infamous seafare princess and her sailors are around here, continue with your exploration. That means I need to watch out for them. Is that it? Great. Shortcut. It's not like I have a choice, right? I kinda need to explore more. Oh, I'm already complete with the area. That's nice. As you proceed through the labyrinth, you find a staircase leading to the new floor. But you suddenly recall what Atelinda told you. You are attempting to explore the new floor, but you realize you need to inform HQ of the princess. You should return to the town and stop at the HQ. Wow, you guys forcing me to return. Great. Thank you, game. Thank you for the freedom. Really? Man! Did you need something? Ah, at first glance, I'd say you are an adventurer hired by McGinnia. Have you started exploring yet? Yeah. I see. Have you noticed anything strange? Labyrinths from other parts of the world? And such? Why do you think that is? I haven't thought about it. But it is strange. Yeah, I was curious about it myself, so I did some research. According to the text, these coincidental appearances are connected to the event from Lemuria's past. It seems in order to save themselves, the Lemuria people borrowed power from the many Yggdrasil's tree across the world. I wonder what happened all those years ago. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to keep you. I'm going to take some time and look around. A little while longer. Bye, man who doesn't even have time to introduce himself. Man, he's rude. As you watch him go, you remember you still need to report, of course. Hi, Gunter. I mean Müller.
Whatever happened to the name Gunter?
Asperia. I'm afraid her highness still isn't feeling well. What? You found a member of the Seafarer Princess Fleet? You don't know of the Seafarers, do you? Virginia has somewhat of a history with them. According to the legend, the Seafarers once attacked us a long time ago. If that's true, then they are indeed our enemies. They don't seem like enemies. I cannot decide our next move on their own. Once Her Highness recovers, I will consult with her on the proper course of action. I'd like you to continue exploring the labyrinth. Sure. Let's register. Wow, I almost have nothing. Okay. Well, I didn't have any encounters during the last things. So it's kind of obvious. Oh well. Let's re-enter! We still need the second floor unlocked, right? Levi, cautious step. At least the staircase is very close to the other staircase. That makes it a little bit easier on me. Even though I already see that there is some floating stuff. Right here. And I see the birds. Flying off to somewhere. Distance. Nice that you have fun, little bird. As you explore the labyrinth, you hear the sound of chirping birds. You look towards the sound and spot three baby birds on the ground. Looking upward, you see a nest in the branch above. The chicken must have fallen out. Luckily, they don't appear to be hurt. You consider whether or not you should help them. Let's help them. Take pity on the baby birds and decide to return them to their nest. The tree branches are thick and stable. You won't have to worry about snapping beneath your weight. You carefully climb up to the nest. As you prepare to place the chicks back in their home, you notice something. The nest is now home to a large round fruit. You're not sure if it fell or was thrown there, but the impact must toss those chicks from the nest. After removing the offending fruit, you return the chicks to their nest and carefully climb down. Back on the ground, you examine the fruit to retrieve from the nest. It's a gray bubble. Great. You accept the fruit as your reward for helping the babies. It's probably a rare drop from take spot, maybe? At least it sounds like a take spot. Oh well. Why did I draw a wall there? There is no wall right there. And that thing seems to be flying in some kind of strange line. But you do you, my good bird friend. You do you. Huh. Is that just an empty room? With something in the center. Where's my E? There's my E. As you explore the labyrinth, you stumble upon a small open area. You take a quick look around, but you don't see anything here. The area is clear of much vegetation and a pleasant breeze tickles your cheeks. Just as you begin to consider taking a short rest, you spot movement in the nearby patch of grass. Is it an animal or a monster? Should you investigate the grass? Of course we investigate. You heed the spirit of the adventurer within you and walk towards the grass to investigate. As you part the tall grass, you discover a monster. The middle of a bloody meal. It seems they think you're here to steal the food. Snarling, they're red up to attack. You must defend yourself if you don't want to become part of their meal. Who is it? Oh, those thing things. I don't remember what they could do, actually. Dash, blind, knob circle. Blind is useful. Knob circle just in case. Why didn't you do anything? Okay, it's one of those fights. I see how it is. Just auto it down and be done with it, right? What did it do to me? Ah, bind resistance, okay. But can you even use a bind or an element? That's the question. But I guess not. No one likes to be interrupted during a meal. Apparently, this goes for monsters too. You take the lesson to heart as you resume your exploration. Yeah, okay, I won't disturb anyone anymore. Sorry about that. But how am I supposed to know that you guys were in the middle of a meal? I mean, I am not a health... man, I forgot the name. Fortune? Teller? No? The guys who can see stuff you are not meant to see. Let's just call them that. That totally makes sense, right? Right. So, let's see. I see there is another tile. I see that there is a door. And I don't see much else. Okay. I check this first. This is just a tech spot. Okay, it was actually a tech spot. Thank you for that. Turn. Let's wait it out. Oh, that's Ha. probably goes on like this. Two tiles front, one tile up, and I see a treasure chest. Too bad that I'm not that greedy to attempt to get past that. So let's just go through the store. Pretend like it never existed, so it doesn't tempt me. And then, do other stuff. That's the plan, right? But Bell? Okay, that's also just a dead end. But what's... As you walk through the flourish labyrinth, you notice a door up ahead. Before it, you can see a number of footprints in the dirt. Don't get too close! After some inspection, you can tell with a certainty that someone traveling through this area quite some time ago. Perhaps you should investigate the area beyond. Perhaps, or maybe you let me do my stuff first, right? Since I happen to find dead ends like nothing else. We get that first. That. Okay, let's check it out before I get out of this area. I missed all that. Hello! You open the door to look inside the small room. There you spot three battle axes planted into the ground with a by the hilt. They look just like the two-headed axe carried by the seafarers. The earth below the axe seems to have been disturbed. God, the weapon must serve as grave markers, or no. You approach to get a closer look. As you do, you feel a strange presence watching you. Oh no! You look around and spot numbers of monsters coming out of the bushes straight at you. There's no time to escape through the door behind you. You will have to make a stand against them. Great! Dire Trim and Raven. Well, I guess Evie is going to take care of them. Well, I take care of the first bird. Knuff circle, right? A poison, but I don't have poison. Defense reduction! Oh god, that's bad. Electric. Healing line. Drop shot. Get that. One of that. Paralyze everyone. How about flame? Huh? How about flame? I'm really not sure about their weakness. That's troublesome, but it seems like it's not piercing. Come on, just die. Just die. Okay. At least I was able to avenge those seafarer guys. What? As soon as you defeat a group of monsters, another wave attacks. Oh. So much for that. At least I get the gun, the whole bird registration quest done. Since those are all birds, right? Isn't that the FOE? That's the FOE. Oh shoot, no. Freezing! We need to make quick work out of them. They are strong. A head bash. Power shot and charming eyes because they are really strong. Oh my god! It's gonna kill us! Defend, defend. Or maybe better. Decoy! Head bash! Oh no, let's defend first. I wanna see how much damage it's going to do. But it's okay! I expected it to be worse. Maybe because he's still in the back line. Maybe I should focus it down as long as it's in the back line. Lay heal. Power shot. And a nerf circle. Just to get some healing out of the way. Okay, I think auto is fine. There we go. Defense, 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 defense. Didn't do it. You could have done that earlier, you know? Instead of taking that pose and threatening me, making me defend even though you didn't do anything. Remembering the request you accepted from the library to register Pedal Bridge Bird. You currently have four kinds registered. It should be easy to satisfy the librarian if you feel that completely ruins the moment just now. You beat back your attackers. Some begin to show signs to retreat. You harness this moment and continue to drive them away. More? Oh my god! That's the stone bird! I see! And if that thing lowers my element resistance, then that thing can just instantly turn me into stone! That's good to know. Weakness? Oh, fire. Better kill that thing quickly then. Punch. Power shot. Nerf circle, right? And nerf circle. Nerf circle is always good. 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 One bird is almost done. Then the ice on the other one. Head bash. Power shot. Let's make them a little bit easier. Die. Then he killed another one, and Levi is things stoned. Ice, the swallow. I do not want him to have that. Just die. Perfect. Okay. Danny, you gonna kill that. You shoot a drop shot on him. Paralyze doesn't seem to work, so how about foot circle, huh? There. That lens should be activated now. From our people, Alicia had to be hit with stone. From our people. Good swallow. Multi shot. Attack. Come on! There we go. We already got another bird. After defeating the unending swarm of monsters, you look around the area, breathing heavily. You immediately surrounded are covered in the blood of the corpse of monster, including that of the giant bird. Among the carnage, you notice a small brass box on the ground. Perhaps one of the monsters ate it by mistake. You pick up the box. It appears to be a decorative container made by the seafarers. Indeed, you find a number of decoration and a letter inscribed on a piece of parchment. Scout log. A sea monster attacked our ship and left us shipwreck here. We've lost all of our documents as well as our guide. We are the only three survivors. We search for our guide, but we're unable to find them. They've sustained heavy injuries. We've heard the monster coming. This will surely be our doom. However, whoever finds this letter, please return our belongings to our people. The short letter ends here. It appears that these eggs mark the grave of those survivors. They must have been buried by other adventurers passing through. These must be the remains of the scouts that Atelinda was looking for. Take the press box with you, hoping you will have the opportunity to return it to where it belongs. You don't see any else of interest here, you pay your respect to the fallen sailors and then leave for your exploration. Oh man. Let's put a tomb here. Poor guys. First they got shipwrecked. Then they were looking for their guide. And they never found it. Really sad. Oh! We are already at 47 minutes, I just noticed. I need to make a cut here, so I hope you guys had fun. And see you in the next part, when we explore more of the Pedal Bridge. Bye!